So my name's Dan Broom. I'm the community minister here at Holminster. In a sense, what we're trying to do is bring the building physically back to its original roots. You know, it was a meeting place. You know, it was a marketplace. It was a place of worship. It was a place where people gathered, where they laughed together, where they cried together. And one of the things that we're beginning to recognise is, though the building is phenomenal and as a place of attraction, people pour into the doors, that people's lives actually are meeting with us in many other different platforms, such as digital.
My job is to make sure that the church has a consistent presence online. Facebook has become really important to us for events. So we have 250,000 people every 90 days see a Holminster event. That's been huge. Instagram's fairly new for us, so we only started in November. But it's just exploded really. Within 3 months, we had 1,000 followers. We're seeing that it's a potentially younger generation who we're reaching to, which churches often find really difficult to engage with. So it's been really, really promising for us. Our ability to reach those who are further afield from us has become more and more apparent. Our podcast has a greater reach outside of the UK than it does within the UK.
People who come from all over the world now, and even online, people who are engaging with us from all over the world. So they'll listen to a sermon, perhaps online, at one of our podcasts on Spotify or iTunes or somewhere, or they'll watch something that's live streamed at a service or an event. Just an endless number of opportunities. And I think what social media and the web can begin to do is make those traditional core values of the faith relevant. So our mission, our vision is to be Holminster, your place to worship, and then from that to enjoy, explore and to belong. We journey with people in some of the deepest and darkest moments of their life and the most joyful as a church. And that is a privilege for me as a community minister and for our staff team, that people are so open and vulnerable in front of us and with us. And a lot of those relationships have started, you know, online.